America's economic machine hits another mark, but it's nothing to crow about. According to many analysts, our debt is now as big as the nation's entire economic output for a year. In other words, if each dollar the U.S. produced for an entire year went to the federal debt, it would just barely pay it off. Fiscal hawk Marco Rubio sees great danger ahead.
The consequences are grave moving forward because not only is the debt high, but according to the Congressional Budget Office and all the experts that are looking at it, there's no plan in place to change that anytime in the near future. It's debt as far as the eye can see.
Conservative economic analyst and author Phil Kirpin says you wouldn't think a country's gross domestic product, or GDP, and its debt would have anything to do with each other, but research shows they do.
When countries get above 100% of GDP, they have real difficulty financing their debt, and it tends to precipitate major fiscal challenges.
And the existence of this debt, without a plan to fix it, is really slowing down the ability of this economy to recover, and people are hurting. Go ask them. You'll see people are hurting. They've lost their jobs. They're working twice as hard, making half as much.
Leading Tea Party Senator Jim DeMint agrees.
Our country's never been here before. We've never had a debt bigger than our economy with a plan to double that debt. There's not that much money in the world to borrow.
In his book, Saving America from Economic Collapse, DeMint points out what the dollar is really worth.
And the only thing that makes that dollar valuable is faith that we can pay our debts, that that dollar is always going to be good. But we have to borrow 43 cents on every dollar we're spending now, and the rest of the world understands that. If you did that as a family or as a business, you're out of business. You're bankrupt.
Some countries in Europe are already facing a debt crisis, and Kirpin says that makes America's financial condition look better than it is.
What's keeping the U.S. afloat right now is that Europe is in so much worse condition than we are, and that there's still a big demand for U.S. debt. And I don't think we can count on being sort of the least dirty shirt in the hamper and that investors will keep putting us on.
DeMint warns that the troubles in Europe could eventually lead to serious ripple effects here in the U.S.
Our banks are heavily invested in Europe. If the euro collapses, dominoes could start to fall this year. And after that starts to happen, people lose confidence in our dollar.
Whether it's a crisis in Europe or just the constantly growing debt, Kirpin and others warn that at some point, the cost of paying back the debt is going up, way up.
Interest rates are going to be sharply higher if we don't change the course of our fiscal policy in this country. You can't keep this going forever.
Then you go from a situation where interest rates are creeping up to moving up to skyrocketing up.
J.D. Foster served in the last Bush White House as chief economist at the Office of Management and Budget. He says doubt in our debt-riddled dollar can quickly turn to disaster, like in Portugal, where interest rates have soared.
In Portugal right now, their 10-year treasury is trading at about 18.7%.
If that happens here,
just interest expense will start to consume an enormous amount of the federal budget.
In other words, it could cost several hundred billion dollars every year just to pay the interest on the debt, in addition to the debt itself. And DeMint warns the U.S. has no one to turn to for help.
We're going to be worse off than Greece because no one can pick us up. No one can bail us out.
It means your entire economy starts to implode.
What Greece has found out is once you're bankrupt, then you can't make your own decisions anymore. Other countries are telling you what you have to do. Our creditors will tell us what to do because, as we know, the borrower is servant to the lender.
So the question is, will the U.S. be its own master in the future? Or will it face a crippling financial crisis because American politicians couldn't control their spending? We'll know the answer soon enough, and we'll all have to live with it. Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.